Alright friends, welcome back to this second part of this tutorial. Alright, in our previous classes we take time to explain each of these buttons. So straight away we'll be going to either new meeting, this new meeting, video on use personal ID, this personal ID, then we start. So coming up, my network is quite cranky, but then we see. So you see on my screen already allows him to have access to your microphone. Yes, got it. So you allow, as you can see, wow, where I am is quite dark. Okay, it's already on automatic record, but I will have to stop it because I know I did that setting, it wasn't supposed to be recording, but let me go back. Remember, Zoom can work based on picture on picture. So let's go back to our setting, or let me just end this. Let me end it. So that is it for new meeting. Then join meeting. This has to do with probably you are joining a class, a meeting. So you must have had the ID and what have you. So this is where you put it, meeting ID. Then you tap here to join. That is it for join. Then schedule, like I said, this is your calendar. So you have a program lineup for the month. You tap on schedule. You schedule each of the program. You schedule. Then you tap done. Once you are through, you tap done. So after which, it pops up the particular date and time it is scheduled for. Then to share your screen, so remember I said I want to go for that setting again. I need to turn off my video since it's a tutorial. Excuse me. My microphone now. I'm the one organizing this meeting. Always show meeting controls. Mm-hmm. Show my connected time. Let me off it. Show name. Okay. Let's go back now. Oh, sorry. Okay. So, how do you share your screen? You may not really have to come here though. So, since you are the one holding this meeting, once you tap on new meeting, then you start meeting, you see the feature on your screen. Okay. Look below the screen. You see different features here. Let me go back again. You see join audio. You see stop video. You can stop this video. You won't see me again. Then you see share. You see participant. You see more. So on this more, you see chat, you see meeting settings, you see whiteboard. So from here, you can raise your hand, no show, send other emojis. Then, when you tap on join, so tap on it. This is where most normally have issue. They will say, "Oh, I am talking, I am speaking, but you guys cannot hear me." So this is where you turn it on. So you allow Zoom to record audio. So here now you are using the device audio. So here you can speak, and you can as well mute it. You unmute, you mute it. Then your video too can go live. You can mute it, but remember, if you're the one organizing the program, you have to go live. Except it's not what that requires you showing your face. Then to record your screen or to share your screen, especially as a trainer, you want to train your followers or audience, students or trainees. So you tap on share. This is the share. Tap on share. So here, it asks you what you want to share. Is it on Microsoft OneDrive, Microsoft SharePoint, Google Drive, Buzz, or is it photo, document, web, bookmark, screen, camera, share, whiteboard? So you will decide what you want to share. If it's a photo, you tap on photo. If it is document you want to share, you tap on. So any of this button you tap, it will take you directly to the portal. So let me share screen, since you want to train. So once you tap on screen, remember it's going to show everything on your screen. This is your screen. This is my screen. So it's going to take you straight to your screen, where you can tap on anything that you want to train your student on. So once you take you to your screen, all you just need to do is to search for that particular app. Let's say this is Play Store. Let me use Play Store as a case study. So once you tap on it, automatically the screen, your student, audience, followers, wherever they are watching from, we have access to your screen and what you do, how to perform that task, or how to perform the things you want to guide them on. All right, it's taking much time to come up. Let me just go back. So that is it about sharing your screen. So now, how do you go back? This is your Zoom. So you can stop sharing screen. See it at the below. Stop sharing screen. Once you are done, go back and tap on it again to stop sharing screen. It will stop. Do you get? Now, like I said before, you have to control. If you want to record your meetings, so how do you achieve that? Let's go back. So this is meeting. This is meeting. Edit. Then you have You have automatically record screen, but it shouldn't be automatic. Let me search for that place again, because yeah. many. All right, friends, I do hope this tutorial really helped you a lot. So if you have any question, do not hesitate to ask. Drop a comment, please subscribe to my channel, like, and turn on your notification button to get latest updates on this channel. Thank you, and do have a beautiful day. Bye for now.